What's going on, everybody? I hope you're having a good day. I hope
you get a paper cut.
You know what I'm saying? You blessed. I hope your life is going good. I hope that girl that you like is, you know, messing with you and all that. But today we're gonna react to Kevin McHale career highlights. So let's see what he got going on. The greatest post moves ever. But let's see what he stacks up, because you got Hakeem, right? Hakeem probably won. Then you got Kobe a little bit after. Then you probably got like the Ewings and the MJs, the Robinsons, the, who else we missing? Leave in the comments who I'm missing. So let's see what he stacks up. Whoa, what is this volume? Huh? Okay. Post. We gotta look at the work before the post. We gotta look at what happens before he gets the rock. Look at this position. This is the freest assist in the history of the NBA. That is a free assist. That's a free assist. Moses came over and made it a little bit more difficult, but that's a free assist. Okay, what are we working with? All right. Okay, what are we looking at? We got people all over the box. We have really no space. One dribble. Nah, he's doing a lot with a little though. That's a lot with a little. I mean, I don't know why defensive highlights are here. I thought it was just post moves. No, these are career highlights, so I guess we could throw some blocks in here. We know McKay wasn't really getting no blocks for real, though. Oh, he made a three. No way he made a three. Okay. Okay, post. Okay, he got a little bit more space this time. We got somebody on the box. We got somebody right next to him. We got somebody one step from the free throw line. And we got somebody on the free throw line, okay? You really only get one dribble. Look at this. What is he working with? See, Hakeem got to at least have all the spacing he wants. Even though Hakeem's drawing the best defender, he doesn't have Larry Bird to draw attention away from him. Hakeem at least got to have more spacing. He not really getting that. Look, he catching it in traffic. He already had to dunk on somebody just to get the rock. Okay. It's tough. He's making a lot do. Good board. Knock it down for me. That's nasty. That's nasty work, but okay. Okay, you see somebody right there. Really, what I would do, probably try to split this double team and get to my right hand. Now, I haven't seen him go left shoulder yet. Yeah, he gonna try to split that double team. I haven't seen him go left shoulder for real, like. I haven't really seen a deep bag. But being a great post scorer is not about having a deep bag necessarily. I haven't seen him shoot anything going left shoulder though. I wanna see something going left shoulder. Okay, you wanna block. Look at the position. This is great position right here. Give it right here. That's great position. Great position. Is that left shoulder? No, that's not left shoulder. But he's still getting money though. I wanna see something going left shoulder. I wanna see like a left shoulder hook, fade away. Look at them long ass arms. He working down there. Oh yeah, he did all his work early. All the post moves early, boom. I spun him, then boom, cooked him. He's fried. Did all my work early. That's what it's about right there. Now the pump fake was low-key unnecessary. But that's how it be though. That was kinda left shoulder drop step. You know they gonna throw some bird highlights in here. Yeah, he gonna stunt you hard. This quality is like, is crazy, I ain't gonna lie. I ain't gonna sit here and lie to you. It's a great pass. You could tell his arms are just crazy long. Okay. Nah, his pump fake be killing dudes. Stay on your feet, Barkley. What are you complaining for? Stay on your feet. Stay on them feet. Oh, I don't think Barkley fouled him, though. It was the other dude that fouled him. But still, stay on them feet. Great defense. I mean, you got 15 people in the lane. You got fucking the whole team's in the lane. You got 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8 and a half feet in the paint. How's anybody scoring in the paint? You got 8.5 feet in the paint. Nobody's scoring in the paint for real. Unless it's MJ. Because MJ's just going above everybody, so. Great position. His positioning is elite, though. Like, his positioning, like, you see this position right here? Like, nobody's disturbing his position. He gonna get to that spot. He gonna plant his flag on the box. And he gonna be here with it. Hit the hand. And that wingspan is nasty work. It's nasty work. And one. He gonna get to that spot. Give it right back. Then give it back again. He gonna go to that middle. I think he likes the middle. I don't think he really likes going baseline. I don't even think he don't like going left shoulder. He loves that middle. But the middle, I mean, you know. Nah, that pump fake is, yeah, he's killing dudes with that pump fake. Oh, give me that. Trying to score in the paint. Okay, middle, watch him go. Oh, he went baseline, all right. That's on me, I'm talking shit. But he proved me wrong, he went baseline. Let's see. He went middle. Yeah, the middle was just like, yeah. I don't blame him, though, because you got more counters you could do in the middle. You go baseline, you most likely have to shoot it. It's like the step through on the baseline, and it's easier to double. You go to the middle, opens up the whole court. You're in the middle of the court. You can make every pass. The baseline, it just limits your options. Look. But he did go baseline right there, though. Double. Nah, I'm chatting. He going baseline, though. Like, I can tell he prefers to go middle, but he's going baseline. He going there. He doing what he need to do. Mm-hmm. Position. You know he gave him that position. Oh, that's nasty work. That's nasty work. That's nasty work. Okay. Talk to him, Mikhail. Not a jump hook baseline, okay. I'm surprised he ain't pump fake right there. Give me that. See Larry Bird would have caught it while running, wrapped it behind his head on some nasty work. Position. Look at that position. The entry passes are easy. Look, give me that. Right to the basket. I'm doing work early. Do your work early. They almost made him go baseline, but then that split opened up. But when you get doubled in the post, the middle, when you split the double team, is usually open, though. You get that nice step through. Usually open. Give me that middle. I'm comfortable. Split that. He didn't really split it, but went around it. Oh, Dr. J got a chill. You wildin'. Good pass. He just comfortable. Yeah, he's majestic with it. Yeah, he's way too comfortable. Somebody do this right here, they're too comfortable. One, two, he's just going through the motions. You might as well be like a trainer. He just going through the motions right there. No dribble, just fade, just get into it. Position, excuse me. Patrick Ewing, bye. High and bye. Position, you know the hand is there. Hit the hand, I do my work early. I'm getting layups now. I'm getting layups off the post up. It's tough. Damn. He a rim protector, low key? That's work. Nah, he actually worked him right there though. He said, huh. That's a trap. But good footwork in the NBA is really traveling though. That's really how you have good footwork, is you gotta travel. If you really break down and look at Kobe's footwork, the nigga is traveling, but the key to a travel is to make it look as if it's not a travel. Look. When you slow it, look at this foot right here. He traveled his ass off, but it's all good footwork. That's how you cap. That's what they call a pro move. But then niggas be mad at James Harden for traveling. But niggas been traveling. MJ been traveling. Let's keep it a buck. Kobe been, Hakeem been, all them dudes been traveling with that pivot. That pivot is not staying down. Like, let's keep it a stack. That pivot is sliding and maneuvering and inching, squeaking and all that. Like, stop playing with it. All these dudes travel. I'm here though. I respect the travel. I'm going to travel too. I ain't hating on nobody traveling. I thought my mic wasn't on. I'm about to be tight. I was about to say, I'm surprised he didn't go for that split. But then he kinda did. Let me see if he traveled again. I just wanna see. I can't really see. Cause Michael Jordan's in the way and the quality is piss. I feel like he did, but I can't see, so I'm not gonna say for sure, but I feel like he did. Oh wait, now we can see, hold on. That might have been clean. I might be hating. Might be a hater. Might just be hating. Nah, he's killing these centers. Like, these centers really can't mess with him. Like, I would think Moses will have him on lockdown. Or these centers, like Ewing, will have him on lockdown. Like, nah, he's still getting money. But he's still getting money against these dudes. Great defense. Nah, Dr. J be trying to lay up everything. Like, take a jump shot. Like, come on. You gotta. That's great anticipation. He don't take, like, bro, take a jump shot, please. I know you Dr. J and you could lay up around the backboard and all that. Chill. Oh.
They're really banging on the boards. Mikhail trying to keep it live.
He just threw it up. Low key should have been a foul. Low key. Ooh. Dang. So was Mikhail better than we actually give credit for? Cause I don't feel like he really gets his credit, really. He a three-time champion, I think. Or at least two. I don't know if every ring Bird won, he won. But he at least a two-time champ. Great post player. At least good defender. At least good. Now, putting this in the highlights is type crazy. Oh, now he had him about like this. Oh, he threw out Mikhail? I mean, that's, I guess he did have him like this. Get that shit out of here, are you crazy? Are they gonna foul? Dang. Oh my goodness. It's not even really a Kevin McHale highlight for real. Wait a minute. Kevin McHale, Celtics all-time leading scorer? I'm confused. Oh, maybe in a game. Oh yeah, so for a single game. Okay, got you.